guys, today I'm going to show you how to make a traditional Christmas stocking with an inside lining. I chose to use 50 star fabric, however you can use any that you like. So let's get started.
Just like the ones I used to know.
To start off with, you need to create your stocking stencil. It doesn't need to look perfect, mine's just stuck together with a few bits of paper. If you're not confident with drawing your stocking freehand, then you can print numerous stencils off the internet. They can be any size, mine's quite small, but that's because it's only intended for a few treats and goodies. You can make yours as big as you want. Next, we're going to place our stencil onto our fabric so that we can start drawing around the edges with some tailor's chalk. If you're worried about the stencil moving around too much, then you can place something heavy on top of it to keep it steady. With every Christmas. In total, you're going to need 4 stocking shapes on your fabric, 2 for the lining and 2 for the outside.
May your days be merry and bright, and may all your Christmases be white.
Once you've finished drawing around all your stencils, it's time to cut them out.
Dreaming of a white Christmas, with every Christmas card I write. May your days be merry.
So this is what you'll end up with. Make sure that if you're using patterned fabric for the outside of your stocking, you cut out one left foot and one right foot. This is so that when you line up the pieces of fabric, the pattern will be on the outside of the stocking. If you're using plain material, then it doesn't matter which way you cut it because it can be left or right, just turn them around. The last piece of material that you need to cut out is the trimming which goes across the top of the stocking. Use the same fabric which you used for the lining so that it creates a nice contrast for the rest of the stocking. To do this, you need to take your stencil from earlier and draw a line across it at the very top, which will be where your trimming will be. This is roughly a few inches, but it can be as big as you want it to. Then you need to place it onto your fabric and draw around it 4 times to create a larger rectangle, which I'll show you how to do now. As you can see, I've created a large rectangle from drawing around the edge of my stencil 4 times. Now make sure you don't cut out the smaller individual rectangles, but you cut it out as one whole shape. So this is what you'll end up with. Now even though we used a stencil to create this shape, it's actually going to be too big. So what you need to do is cut off about 1 centimeter from the edge of the fabric.
To make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to see.
Before we start sewing, we need to pin the material together. So take the 2 pieces of lining, pin around the edges, but leave a gap at the top so that it looks like a sock. Do the same again for the outer fabric. However, if you're using patterned material, you need to make sure that it's inside out so that the pattern is actually on the inside. To pin the piece of trimming, we need to fold the fabric over lengthways. And then fold it again. So that now we have a quarter of the size. Then pin along the edge, like so. So let's start sewing. Set your machine up as you normally do. I've chosen a high thread tension because the material I'm using is quite thin. I've also chosen to use a simple straight stitch. The first thing we're going to sew is the outside material. Sew along the edges where you've pinned, but leave a gap at the top. You need to do the same again for the lining. Sew around the edges. However, this time you need to leave about 1 inch gap. It doesn't matter where in particular you leave this gap, however, it will be easier to do it along a straight seam. This will be important later as you're going to pull the stocking through it. For the the trimming, simply sew along the edge that you pinned.
So I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from one.
To begin assembling your stocking, you need to invert the outer material so that the pattern is on the outside. Also, invert the trimming. Next, we're going to place the trimming onto the stocking. Make sure that the seams line up at the back of the stocking and that the open edge of the trimming also lines up with the open edge of the stocking. If you'd like to add a hook to your stocking, like the one which is on this one, then you're going to need a piece of ribbon, any colour, any size. We're then going to attach this ribbon to the seam which is on the back of your stocking, here. Just use a pin and pin it to the back, like so. So now, the edge of the ribbon, the edge of the trimming, and the edge of the stocking outer should all be lined up. Next, we're going to take the stocking and tuck it into the lining.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas.
Make sure that all the edges are now aligned and begin to pin along the outside. Do not pin the stocking shut. So you'll end up with something that looks like this. Now we're going to sew up these edges.
Once again, as in olden days.
Now you're almost finished. Remember the hole I told you to leave earlier? Well, now we're going to use it. Open the hole and pull the entire stocking through it. So far, the stocking is through, the hook is through, the trimming is through. Just finish pulling the last bits of the lining. Your finished product will look a little something like this, which appears to be two stockings sewn together. However, the lining still has a hole in, which you can't leave open, or toys and chocolates will slip through. Therefore, you have to sew this hole up. You can either do this by hand or by machine. I appreciate that it's going to look a little bit messy, but you won't see it because it's inside. Once you've sewn up your gap, all that's left to do is push the lining into the stocking, and it's complete. So here we are, the finished traditional Christmas stocking, ready to fill with Christmas presents. If you're interested in watching any more sewing videos, or have a passion for anything vintage, then check out my blog at vixenshomefront.blogspot.co.uk. Thank you for watching, and have a very Merry Christmas.